Hello, my friends.
And welcome back, everyone, to ARK, Scorched Earth. Today we return Taco. He broke his back or something like that. He's recovering inside somewhere in here. Speaking of inside, we went ahead and crafted ourselves one of these. I threw a bunch of stuff in here because today we got a little bit of a goal in mind. A, we need some food. We're borderline starvation. Oh no, that's not good. I'm just gonna need some raw meat. I pissed off everyone in the comments, but I'm gonna do it. We need to start advancing tool-wise. So we might have a metal hatchet, a metal pike and stuff, but we gotta start getting some materials to start crafting. We definitely need a metal pickaxe as well. And really, we just gotta get metal stuff. So like, if we look at the engrams, not even focusing on Scorched Earth, just the prime ones, right? There's still some pretty basic things we gotta try and knock out. Mainly, like, the metal hatchet, the pike, the pick, the terror bird saddle, not to mention a bunch of other stuff. The crossbow, that's going to be a big one. And there's a bunch of stuff we got to do, especially because we want to get on track to taming a rock elemental. Because here's the thing, if we tame the rock elemental is amazing at killing death worms. We got to kill death worms to be able to tame mantises, and mantises are super cool. So right there, that's a ton of stuff we got to do, and we're going to begin doing it. So that's why today I am traveling extra lightweight. Only got the bare necessities plus a lot of arrows just in case. I got about, 58 pounds on me. Mothra over here. I'm actually going to level up Mothra's weight a little bit. Does not go up at the most, but we are going to be flying and pretty much just trying to grab some metal for ourselves. Now, we are going to multitask, and also when we get back home, hopefully I remember to name the vultures, because I have a name in mind thanks to you guys. It's a name that means quite a bit to me personally, but also is one that you guys really like. So we're gonna go start going to these cliffs, and here's the cool thing, right? We might, if we're lucky, find out and have an encounter with a rock elemental. And that's kind of what I'm hoping for, because a rock elemental encounter, while hopefully we live and stuff, it'd be really cool to get to see one in action that isn't in dreamland, because we've yet to encounter one, and we gotta try and start scoping out the areas they might be in. And along with that, I mean, we can grab some metal from up here, so it's a win-win. So what we're going to try to do here is just fly pretty low next to these rocks, since these are the rocks that they can be. And, oh, is that a terror? That's a terror bird. All right, we got to land on kind of friendlier rocks where we might not get attacked. Oh, that's a thorny dragon. What up, dude? And there's also an Argentavis up there. I don't want to piss that thing off. We're not in the best situation here, because this, our mount is not going to be... Ooh. We might want to try and tame up an Argentavis pretty soon. Actually, now that I think about it, that's probably a good game plan for us. But down here, that's what we're going to do. We're going to be flying low next to these rocks, because if you fly low, you can potentially unearth the... That's what they're hidden as. That's what the whatchamacalls are disguised as. They disguise themselves as rocks. And we got to find out what those rocks look like, so then we can better be prepared for when, you know, we're actually trying to go out and tame one. The thing is, to try and tame one... Why am I getting only stone? I know I have a crappy pickaxe, but come on, man. See, this is also why we gotta work on getting the metal pick, right? Because this stuff is not cutting it. Now, the good thing is the metal pick isn't too much. I think it's like one metal ingot or something. So we should be able to craft one up relatively easily. But still, let's make sure that our stamina's up and ready. But yeah, I want to figure out which one of these is going to be the rock elemental, if there is one. And then once we do find a place where we might find a rock elemental, we gotta find a place where we can tame one effectively, because there's a certain strategy to taming rock elementals, right? Pretty much the strategy is you wanna... yo, is that a cave? Hold up, that might be a cave. Oh, damn. Yeah, pretty much the strat for taming rock elementals, though, is you wanna trap them, and then you gotta apply trauma to their head, long story short. So what's that mean? You gotta shoot them in the head with rockets. From what you guys have been saying, I don't know you can do it with rockets. I only know you can do it with cannonballs and catapults. That's the two I know you can do it with, so that's what we are going to be trying to do. That's a vulture over there. I thought that was a mini Argentavis. I'm like, what? That's in the game now? There's a Carno up there. Let's try to escape that thing. I do want to go in here, see where this goes. Is this a cave we've discovered? On accident? No, it's just a cool little underpass. It's actually really cool. This would be like a solid base location. Okay, I don't know if it'd be a good one, but it'd be a cool one to say the least. You know, just build some gates at each end. You even got like a little couple holes in the sky you might be able to break through. There's some cool potential there, but Sorry also, let's ditch some of the stone. Sorry also that over the next couple days, there might not be a ton of videos. I'm trying to definitely get minimum one ARK out, and then if I can, hopefully another video of some sort. It might not necessarily be ARK, since these definitely do take a little bit longer for me to make than my other types of videos. But I did just want to let you guys know about that, because just my week right now, pretty much Wednesdays are extra bad for me, school-wise, scheduling-wise. I just got worse, because now I'm doing something from 7 to 8, so literally on Wednesday, I wake up at 8, I come home at 8 on a good day. So I'm not currently in a super fun situation, so just Wednesdays are gonna suck, and then also Thursday I have a career fair, another one. Today was one, went pretty well actually, so thank you to everyone who wished me well in the comments. I appreciate a ton of that, but I'm gonna be doing that on Thursday. So Thursdays are usually pretty chill for me. I only have like two classes. Well, now I get to go to a career fair and be hot and sweaty in a suit for, you know, an extended amount of time. Man, the college life. But it's okay, after this month, like, all the career fairs are done and I have to stop worrying about that. But yeah, that's what's been going on in my life. Hopefully your life is a little bit less stressful and just a little bit more on the fun side, because after all, fun is what there is. I mean, I'm still having fun, I still love it, even if it might be 10 p.m. I get to come home and I just get to record some ARK. But like, I can't ask for anything else in the world. I get to record ARK, and I get to presumably make you guys smile, and I also get to hit 80 stones in a row and get like 2 metal. We're not getting any metal, god damn. So yeah, okay, now that the metal's done, Argentavis is over there. Yeah, we're really over encumbered. I say we YOLO this, right? Why don't we try and tame an Argentavis? Why not? Who says we can't? Really, can we even, actually, I don't know. I should probably research Argentavi and see if like we can bola one first, because I definitely want to, I don't know if I want to get into a pissing contest with an Argentavis yet. Maybe get some chitin armor first before we do that. And then I'm not sure if bolas work on them, so I'll look into that. Worst case, we'll do that next time while we continue our search for rock elementals and getting plenty of this. I want to make sure to keep on skimming on the rocks, because I just need a ton of metal. This should be enough after this. I'm going to start flying home kind of soon. Let's avoid that Argentavis, because that thing will do bad things to us. Like, honestly, our moth cannot compare to what an Argentavis can do damage-wise. Like, sure, but actually, if we poop on the Argentavis, we could probably escape. You know what? Why don't we go to the top of the mountain? Let's see if we can't find that rock elemental. All right, we got another Mothra there. We got another Lamantria. We got another moth letting us know that it's safe. So it's safe. Let's take this opportunity to see if there is a rock elemental up here. And if there is, you know, let's say hello. And then run like hell, but let's say hello, right? So let's get our stamina back. We got a poop, get a little Lamantria poop out there. And I mean, all we got to do is just fly by some rocks and hopefully trigger it. You know what I should do? I should search exactly what they look like. So I knew there's kind of like a specific look to them. Also, while we're here, this might honestly be a good chance. Why are these rocks like, oh, those are the pure metal rocks. Those are way better for metal. We should have been hitting those the entire time. What I was gonna do here, we got obsidian. Ah, beautiful. Let's grab some crystal while we're here. Do we need the metal pickaxe? I think we need the metal pickaxe before we even begin to drop crystal. Okay, never mind. We'll be back with the metal pickaxe. God damn it. Let's make sure we drop those extra stones there. Like I said, don't want to be weighing this guy down. We got an extra rare mushroom, though. I can tell that our friendly caravan taco probably spent a ton of time up here. And I'm just trying to, like, see if we can't trigger one of these rocks. Triggered! But it doesn't look like it, so. Alright, let's just start making our way back home. I think that is from whence we came. And as you can see, I mean, we got the mountain range super close to us. And this mountain range goes on for a little while. Over there to the left, we got the sand dunes. That's where the death worms can be encountered. We have this close-up mountain range. A couple more mountains that-a-ways. Obelisk all the way over there. And before we go too far, let's definitely land. Just so we can land in a kind of safe place. Right next to where Akarno's murdering something. But let's land in a kind of safe place. Then we'll continue heading out. Ah, it would have been so cool to encounter a rock elemental. I don't know, we'll keep looking. Anyways, I'm gonna get home here, cut through that, and once we're there, we're gonna start progressing a little. All right, and we are back. One crafted forge later, some smelted metal later, and we're up to 42 ingots, and this should allow us quite a good amount of stuff to be made. And now, mainly one big thing that we're gonna be going for soon, and that we really want to get, is we want to get up to the fabricator. That's gonna take us 35 metal ingots, 20 cementing paste, 50 spark powder, 15 crystal, 10 oil. None of that should be too hard, so the good news is we should be able to get a fabricator going within the next episode or so, to be completely honest. So we're going to be advancing a lot technologically, and when we advance technologically, good things will happen. But before we even talk about that, let's go to the weapons. Let's go to the melee. We want to make a metal pick, so we will make a metal pick. We need that just because it will literally give us way more of a capacity to make way more metal, pretty much, because then we'll be able to mine way more and just sow the benefits from there. So now we have all metal stuff. Crossbow would still be nice. I don't know, when do we get the crossbow? What do we need for that? If we get a little bit more fiber, you know, crossbow. Welcome to the family. Who needs a bow? Say hello to the crossbow. And we've upgraded our stuff a good amount. So while we are upgrading, why don't we go ahead and upgrade our armor along the way to desert or desert chitin. Let's definitely do the helmet, since that's the one thing we don't have out of the other stuff. And then we'll continue with the legs are the most expensive. We could get a pair of legs and a pair of the chest piece. But after that, we do run out of chitin. I thought we had more chitin. So, I think I put it away. Maybe able to craft up this full chitin armor, and yeah, we'll be able to advance a very good amount here. We are dehydrated, good thing. We got our lovely lady Lumps over here. Hello, Lumps, give me your water. Haha. And we're gonna continue crafting. I love smashing for that fact. Literally, we don't even need to build a designated workbench once we have a saddle. Although you need to build one in the first place to build a saddle, but that disproves my point, so ignore it. And then we got the two chitin. We have helmet, legs, chest piece, so we want hands and gloves. Let's get those done. Gloves. Hands and gloves. Boots and gloves. That's what I meant to say. And after that, we've crafted up pretty much our battle armor, once we do want to run into battle. Oh, still can only craft the thorny dragon saddle. And at this point, we're going to be saving up for the fabricator. We got to get one more metal ingot. That shouldn't be too big of a deal. We will be able to gather crystal now due to our metal pick. Oil we just get from an oil jug bug. Spark powder is going to be from flint and stone in the mortar and pestle. And then cementing paste is going to be chitin / keratin and stone. So fabricator should be done. I'm going to go ahead and grind a little bit. And hopefully we'll be able to end this episode on a fabricator note. And also on naming some vultures. You know, no. We don't wait here. We're going to be naming the vultures. So as you guys know, there are three vultures. Now I think I saw multiple comments. Some were more highly rated than the other, but here, right, so we have, oh my god, that's horrifying. Here we have our vulture. Someone said I double click F. I was pressing the wrong button. I thought it was like double click E. You double click F, and then once you do that, there you go. Gonna crank up their melee damage. Also, the thing is, they can have normal meat in their thing. They can have normal meat, but they have to harvest it naturally, so you have to send them to harvest something. That's how they normally get it. But what they do with the meat in their inventory, they're pretty much like a refrigerator. So if they harvest some prime meat for you, that prime meat is going to stay good for a really good amount of time. So having one of these along with you if you're taming is actually going to be pretty useful. And along with that, we're going to keep on going up in melee damage. Honestly, there's a lot of useful taming mounts, so the vulture is going to be good for holding your prime meat if you tell it to harvest a dead body. And then where's the other one? Mothra, since Mothra can slow down other dinos. I don't know if that works on all dinos. I don't know if the big dinos it'll work on. Let's keep on going up. I do want to have your weight kind of high here, since we're going to be doing some runs. And yeah, so let's go ahead, start naming. And of course, what we are going to name these are our favorite trio. I love this show as a kid. You know, maybe you guys remember it too, but Ed. Ed, where's Ed? Where's Ed, aka Double D. And who's last? I hope I don't spell this wrong. I'm gonna do the wrong version of Eddie, but pretty sure it's that Eddie. Ed, and Eddie. Woohoo! You guys have to remember that show from when you were little, right? You got Ed, Double D, and then Eddie, right? That's what they were known as. That's just going to be Double D. But yeah, so apparently Double D, the smarticle particle of the group, is the strongest, which makes no sense. But I'm going to go ahead and we're going to go back to the mountain, hopefully encounter a rock elemental if we're lucky. But if not, we'll get the rest of the stuff we need and we'll get some fabricator crafting going and continue expanding our house. And then probably in between episodes, I'll put some finishing touches on the house so at least kind of resembles a house or something. Alright guys, so I was flying around and, you know, just minding my own business over here on my moth. I mean, not minding my own business, I was actually just, you know, stealing from the mountain. And, I noticed a little something. We didn't actually get to the crystals yet, we'll get there in a sec, but... do you guys see what I see? Because that rock, the color of that rock is sketchily out of place. I think we might have on our hands what we are looking for. The question is, do we? I don't know. There's also a Karna right there, which is kind of sketchy. Let's go down. Let's see what this does. Hello. Oh, yep. That's it. That's what I... Oh my God. That thing's massive. Oh, don't throw rocks at me. Okay. Is he like a lava? Is he lava? Why is he lava? What the hell? He's like so red and stuff. Why is he red? Okay, well, there we have the rock golem in his natural habitat. I don't know if that is his... I hope that's his natural habitat. Anyways, we got the rock golem there in his natural habitat, throwing rocks and things. Let's see if we can get a whiff of what level he is without... Oh, no, I don't want to live. I want to live, though. I want to live, so maybe not. God, he's massive. Look at him. I wonder if dropping a spore on him will slow him down. Is that a thing? Can we slow him down? That's what I want to try, at least. I'm experimenting with the rock elemental. Can we poop out some spores on him? I don't know. Maybe. Hello, rock elemental. Oh, we gotta land soon. Never mind. Abort. We're making bad decisions. Okay. Oh! Did he just attack the Karna or me? I don't know. He's coming for me, though. Don't attack me, babe. Don't attack me. There's a Karna attacking you. He's a bigger threat. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for pooping on you. There you go. Take my spores. Do you want those spores? Come on, go into... Okay, so I don't know if the spores affect him. That's really what I wanted to find out here. Let's try again. See if we're right above him. There we go. Poop. Will the spores slow him down? No, it doesn't look like it matters. Well, there we have it. Hopefully we remember this. We'll come back to this rock elemental. And we'll see what's up here, but... yeah, there you have it, guys and girls. The rock elemental. We encountered one. Now, that's what we're going to be taming, and I'm kind of scared. I'm going to be very scared, but we'll find a way. We just got to do a lot of head trauma to it. I think we got to try and get it stuck in a good location, and then hopefully we can get it knocked out, unless we just have a ton of rocket launcher ammo, and me and Taco take, like, the cheap way out and just grind a ton of rockets. But we will see. Other than that, though, I'm going to continue getting some crystal. I'll meet you guys back at base, and we'll kind of recuperate, take in everything we did. Alright guys, we're back at base. We got some metal. Actually, no, I already put the metal into Thorny over there. What I meant to say was we got some stuff crafting up here. Last little bits of cementing paste, ton of spark powder. Probably gonna be in a good amount of this in the future anyway, so I decided to pretty much just max use our flint. And I had a lot of fun getting all those rocks too. Woo! Gotta love the rocks. So many rocks. God have mercy on my soul. And here we are coming back. We got a little bit of oil from some oil jugabug. And then we got the spark powder. And then we got the cementing paste. And is that all that we need to craft the fabricator? Hello, fabricator. Fantastic to finally make your acquaintance. Well, we know where this is going. This is going in the crown jewel room. Because pretty much what I'm doing here, the game plan, how this is working, right? I'm pretty much trying to line this wall. Get out of there, Ron Burgundy. Why are you pooping on my wall, dude? This is going to be a good wall. I'm pretty much trying to line this wall with opportunity. All right? And part of that opportunity is going to be the fabricator. Actually, a pretty big part of it. Boom. We got the fabricator. We got some advancements coming down Sesame Street. And also, that means we got some good engrams we got to utilize. And there's some stuff we gotta do. I know that there's the shotgun. Let's go ahead. Let's just check out a couple things. We need the flare gun for that. Let's get the flare gun. We need gunpowder for that. Okay, wow, we're so far. There we go. Flare gun, shotgun. Then we can research the chainsaw once we get the shotgun. Oh, look at that chain bola. Ooh, hoo, hoo, hoo. We gotta use the ballistic turret for that. Anyways, no, back on topic. In terms of Scorched Earth Engrams, we are gonna wanna get some power going. Wind turbine's gonna be pretty big in that. So I'm just trying to research a couple things here, and then we'll go ahead and see how that all plays out. We need the electrical generator, get the oil pump. That's gonna be cool to get the oil pump going, but really, next thing down the list is if we're not doing work towards... Actually, no, that's what we gotta do. We gotta do work towards rocket launcher. Where are you, rocket launcher? For you, we need the long deck rifle. There we go. I'll research ammo when I need it. Then we need the rocket launcher. That's how we're gonna wanna tame this thing. We gotta learn the grenade first. And, we're gonna need a lot of stuff to make it work. But we will make it work. We'll get a rock elemental within our grasp. And life will be amazing. Then if we can't get this to work, I think we can get the cannon. But I think we need the catapult first, right? Catapult, and then for that, oh my god, it's just a long chain of, what did I misspell? Ballista? There we go, ballista, okay, never mind. And then we go to catapult, and then we go to cannon. So there, we got the basics here. Cannonball, I'll get there eventually. But just look at how much some of this stuff's gonna craft and kinda get a feel for how long it'll be till we can potentially start trying to take out this rock elemental. But I mean, in between, we'll of course build up the trading outpost. Probably go on some gun-related adventures for getting some good stuff as well. And we got a lot of stuff, but we encountered a rock elemental today. That was exciting. Wish I could be more excited, but it's getting kind of late here. I'm recording this the night before Wednesday because I gotta go crazy. Like, I'm gonna be gone all day, like I mentioned. Seriously, by the time you're watching this, just wish for mercy on my soul, because I'm gonna need it. But if we look at the fabricator here, wind turbine, we need electronics. Ooh, we need electronics. Well, we'll get that going, and then we can turn wind into electricity. The cool thing is if you hit H, it lets you know the wind percentage there. We're at 65% west is how strong the wind is here. So our wind turbine will be decent, you know, won't be awful. The rocket launcher, though, 80 polymer, 50 metal ingots, 60 cementing paste. Long story short, a very, very long grind. And then for every rocket we want to get, it's going to be even longer of a grind. So we're going to start working on that. I'm going to start doing some research, see exactly how much we need. But then, of course, we also have the chainsaw here. We're going to try to get one of these crafted pretty soon because I just want to use a goddamn chainsaw. That sounds awesome. So I'm going to try to get one of these crafted pretty soon. I don't know what ammo it uses, anything like that. But all of that we will get figured out. But on that though, a lot of progress in today's episode. Hopefully you did enjoy. If you did, let me know in the comment section by letting me know also what we should be doing. And then I will give you guys another chance here to name the direwolf. I didn't name these guys, but, you know, the main focus of that episode was the vultures. This episode, I'm going to dedicate to the direwolf. So if you got a name for this guy, comment section down below. Go ahead and leave it there, lads and lassies, right? Leave a comment letting me know what you think our direwolf should be named. And then go look through the comments, you know, like any comments that you see that you kind of agree with. And then I'll hopefully pick up some of you guys and get it going. But other than that is going to do it for me. I'm dying of thirst. I need some water. Get over your camera ups. Ironic that I'm getting water from camera ups, but eventful episode. Hopefully tomorrow is just as, if not more eventful, and hopefully Taco fixes his back eventually so he can join us. But those master traders, man, they're a unique breed, so we're in for some adventures. But on that though, plenty left to do in ARK Scorched Earth, and I cannot wait to do it. That's going to go ahead and do it for me. Also, do keep an eye out on the channel for some other games, like when Halo launches for PC. Oh, ho, ho, I'm going to be doing some hilarious and awesome custom games with that. Black Wake is getting a huge update this weekend. There's a couple of things I'm going to be posting. But yeah, on that, that's going to do it for me. Thank you guys so much for watching, and goodbye, my friends.